Hello again, everybody, and welcome back to Polly's Pantry. I'm Polly Pitch, and today we're going to be doing some super elevated appetizers for a particular game that's coming up in about a week or so. And these appetizers I'm going to show you are great for cocktail parties, great for a big game, even though the Green Bay football Packers will not be representing themselves in the upcoming game. I'm very disappointed about that, but we're going to plug forward here. These appetizers are great for a game, great for a gathering, great for a cocktail party. Cool for date night too. So what we're gonna be doing today is a play on sausage and peppers. And we're gonna have a sausage stuffed pepper. I found these little mini bell peppers at the grocery store. We're gonna make a quick sausage filling. Some Italian sausage, some mozzarella cheese, breadcrumbs and Romano cheese. Stuff those and bake those off. We're also gonna be doing a pork tenderloin Marsala, making a little slider out of it. So I'm gonna show you a real basic Marsala recipe to do with pork or chicken or even shrimp if you wanna really liven things up a little bit. And then a really simple, pretty tasty little play in a BLT with arugula, crispy prosciutto, and fresh tomato. And again, we're just gonna use these little silver dollar rolls that we got from the local grocery store. As always, wouldn't be Polly's Pantry without a glass of wine. Today we have an Argentine Malbec. And Malbec is real similar to a Merlot, just a little bit more full body, a little bit more acid, a little bit more tannin. Thought this would go well with the appetizers. Even though these are gonna be kind of light, the full body wine will bring it to life. So let's get going and make some appetizers. Okay, we're back and ready to start our prosciutto, arugula, and tomato, kind of open-faced little sandwiches here. Before we get going, I want to thank everyone for subscribing to our YouTube page and for checking out our Facebook page. We are pushing 100 friends on Facebook. Thank you, thank you. And we are over, quickly approaching 450 views on YouTube. Personally, I would have been happy with about 40, but right now we're at over 400 views on YouTube. Thank you very much for that. Go ahead and subscribe to the page, click the notification button so you don't miss any of our little episodes here. And we're gonna kick in and make our sandwiches. Kind of cheated here and made a few ahead of time. Really, really simple. These hold very, very nicely. I'm gonna show you how to assemble them in just a second. To kind of get ahead on everything, we got our oven preheated at 375 degrees. As we build our stuffed peppers, we're gonna bake them off in the oven. So just super simple and really pretty tasty. I just toasted up these silver dollar rolls. A little bit of a schmear. Plain old regular mayonnaise. Nothing fancy. Nothing crazy. You don't have to make an aioli or emulsify anything. Got some really nice arugula here from the local store. Arugula kind of looks like a dandelion green. Very peppery, very flavorful. Really, really good. Kind of elevates a sandwich a little bit. And then with the rest of this arugula, I've got a bag of spinach in the fridge and a little bit of fresh basil from the Italian market down the street. Gonna make a pesto with spinach, arugula, and the basil. Plain old tomato, kind of lightly salted and peppered. And here's our crispy prosciutto. What we did with that was we put it on a baking sheet on a wire rack, and we baked it for about 12 minutes till it became nice and crispy, and then drop it on the floor like we just dropped that piece right there. But there you have it. I mean, a really simple, fun little play on a BLT with arugula, fresh tomato, and crispy prosciutto. Okay, now on to our sausage and stuffed peppers, but just a quick note about the prosciutto I forgot to mention before. This isn't the $25 a pound prosciutto de Palma stuff. This is the stuff that you'll find in any grocery store, cryovac and ready to go. Again, at 400 degree oven on a baking rack, cooling sheet, let it roast for about 12 minutes. Got it really nice and crispy. Makes a killer play on a bacon and egg. Makes some great bacon bits too. For a salad if you're looking for something different. On to the sausage. I've got two links of sausage here, about a half a pound. And all we're gonna do, just cook it off really quickly. just like you would meat for a chili or for a stew. Kind of break it up, get a little color on it. This particular Italian sausage has bell pepper and provolone cheese into it, so it's really flavorful. And keep in mind that it's going to roast in the oven for a little bit too. And I want to cook it to death. I don't want to cook it all the way. It hasn't really been in here 5 minutes. We're starting to get a really nice flavor. And this little bit of sausage will yield quite a bit. We're pulling on our best friend here, our little shorty white wines. And just a little bit. Kind of clean up the bits from the sausage, give it some flavor, and just let it reduce. Smells incredible. And again, baked with the bell pepper, it's going to really be a very flavorful, very nice appetizer. We're going to let that reduce and cool for a little bit, and then we are going to stuff our little mini bell peppers, make a cool little appetizer. Be right back. Okay, our sausage is cooled off and ready to be mixed up. I've got the sausage just in a plain old mixing bowl. I'm going to put in about half a cup shredded mozzarella, about half a cup plain old store-bought toasted breadcrumbs. Don't need panko, don't need anything too serious, nothing too crazy, just real simple. More for a binder. A couple of shakes. Romano cheese. And again, you don't need a whole lot of seasoning in here with the sausage being so flavorful. And just gonna mix this up a little bit. That's it. You don't want it the consistency of a meatball. You want it a little bit looser than that. And for these little mini peppers, again, found these at the grocery store. Just cut the top off. I like to save the top of the thing to make kind of a cool garnish. Just split them in half. Rinse them out a little bit of water, and you get this cool little boat, little vessel here for our sausage. And again, very, very simple. About a spoonful of our mixture. Just pack it in there. Not like that. Onto our baking sheet. And we're gonna finish stuffing these and put those in a 375 degree oven. About 15 to 20 minutes. Okay, our peppers are stuffed and ready to go. I've got 10 peppers, 20 pieces, and you'll see I've got quite even a little bit left over. So half a pound of sausage, a little bit of cheese and some breadcrumbs goes a long way. 375 degrees, set a timer so I don't forget to remember for about 20 minutes. And we will start our Marsala. Think of Marsala, you think of chicken or veal. Today we're gonna make it with a pork tenderloin. I found some pork tenderloin at the local grocery store here. They were 2 for 1. And in each pack, there's actually 2 loins. So I wound up with 4 pork loins for 11 bucks. And I've got a dozen cuts here so far of the pork loin from just one of the single ones. And all you do, take it out. If you think of the loin like this, 90 degrees, 45 degrees. Really simple. A simple slice. That easy. And what I like to do is take it between 2 Ziploc bags. Onto the counter. There we go. Rolling pin that you use for a pizza or for a pie crust. A nice even piece here. It's going to cook really quickly. It's going to be super tender. Hit the cymbal and away we go. And I think that gives me 14 cuts out of the one pork loin. Same thing with the mushrooms. I've got about a half dozen just plain old white button mushrooms here. And I'll show you a quick trick. We take the stem out. Can save the stem to compost, to make a stock, to do whatever. Got a fresh knife here. And again, you're not gonna go like a ninja warrior. You're not gonna be like that guy in Psycho. You're just gonna take the mushroom, make some nice even slices out of it. Really, really simple. And again, stem out. You can freeze these for a vegetable stock, for some chicken stock. And again, the mushroom, very, very, very simple. Just a nice slice. All right, we'll set up and start getting ready to make our pork tenderloin a la Marsala. We're gonna make a little slider out of it. Time for a little more Malbec. Why not? Okay, and as you'll see, again, we are a little overly organized, as we like to do here. So you see the process with everything and all the steps together. We're gonna flour our pork loin. Just kind of brown it, put it on the side in a pan. Throw in our mushrooms. We're gonna reduce, instead of a expensive Italian Marsala wine, we're gonna use a cooking sherry today. There's all types of wines. Marsala is about 20 bucks a bottle, 17 to 20 bucks a bottle, depending on where you get it and what you buy. But we're gonna use just a plain old cooking sherry. You can buy again at any grocery store. And then I'm gonna show you a trick how to make that gravy just super decadent, super thick. We got a tablespoon of cornstarch mixed up with about a quarter cup of cold water. We're gonna make a little slurry in there. It's not gonna affect the flavor, but it's gonna make it just this gorgeous, thick, delicious Marsala gravy. So we've got our pork loin, and we're all set here. Just a sprinkle or two of salt and a shake or two of pepper onto the pork loin. And really nice and light in the flour. I've got about a half a stick of butter. Slowly melting in here. And I'm gonna add a shot or two of vegetable oil. Again, vegetable oil is gonna help for the butter not to burn so quickly. Again, we don't want a brown butter. We just want a plain melted butter for this. Goes pretty quickly. And again, once you understand this, you can do it with the chicken breast. I like to do it with shrimp from time to time, something a little bit different. Something not so in the mainstream. Beautiful pork loin. This will certainly make a meal with some vegetables. It's outrageous over a mashed potato with that Marsala gravy we're gonna make in just a minute here. Goes really well over pasta as well. Okay, I think we can start with that. And again, got our butter all set here. Let's move in just a touch closer so you can see what the hell I'm doing here. Got the pan on medium heat. Again, I don't want to fry it. I don't want to overcook it. I just want to kind of get a color on it. And again, we're gonna purposely lay these in a clockwise pattern. Because then we know what to flip first. We start at 12 o'clock, work our way around. This will hold really, really nicely if you wanna make it ahead of time. You can even make it the day before. Put it in a foil pan and just warm it up. can cut the pork loin the day before and the mushrooms have everything prepped and just worry about putting the dish together the day of. All right, should be able to see that. Turn it up just a touch. Should give you just enough time for a glass of wine while the stuff heats up and while we're waiting for it to brown. All right, you'll see the butter. Again, the pan's gonna talk to you. You'll see the butter starting to kick in a little bit. I'm gonna turn it down just a touch. Because again, I don't want a really hot pan. I just wanna get a little bit of color onto the pork. Same thing with the chicken breast. I made some Marsala the other night. I took kind of practice up for this. I didn't butterfly the chicken breast. I didn't pound the chicken breast. Plain old store-bought chicken breast. Browned it out of the pan and kind of let it baste in the gravy there, perfectly cooked. And just with the pork, because we're making a sandwich out of it, we want it real nice and thin. All nice and even. And it should only take a couple of minutes aside to get a color. If it does get too hot, does get kind of out of control, you can add another pat of butter or just a spritz of oil. Kind of help you out. And, not let it get away from you so much. And then right from the top, from 12 o'clock. Not rocking around the clock, we're marsaling around the clock here. That's all we want. Just a nice little color on it. And turn it down just a touch. And then I'm gonna move the flour. Kind of get ready for our next step. So the next step's going to be the mushrooms. Got 2 cups of sherry cooking wine in there. I don't know that we're going to need that much, but I got it. And I've got our slurry here. Again, just a teaspoon of cornstarch into some nice cold water. All right, now. And again, don't forget the Marsala on the clock. Right around the pattern, nice and evenly cooked. Already smells great. Now comes the fun part. We're gonna toss in our mushroom with just a turn or two of pepper. A shaker to a salt. Let this pick up all the butter, all the flavor, all the little bits, the extra flour from that pork loin. I'm gonna throw in just a little bit more butter. Mushrooms will act like a sponge and they will absorb everything very, very quickly, which is great though, because you want the flavor to be in the mushroom as you're going along. Just want to get this incorporated and get this melted. See how much they grab that butter. In just a second or two, already got a really nice browning onto these. And now for the fun part. I got the gas up to a medium high heat. Anytime that you add alcohol or something flammable, a cognac, a wine, a sherry, put it in another vessel. If you put it from the bottle and the flame gets into the bottle, you're gonna have a pretty major disaster on your hands. So I've got to cook the sherry. I'm gonna put in about a cup and a half. Get that going. Let that reduce and all the alcohol cook off. Again, this is when you drive everybody crazy. This smell is just absolutely amazing. And if you see, kind of a watery consistency right now. So again, I want it to cook down a little bit, get it nice and bubbly. Get alcohol to cook off. And then, again, we've got a really watery consistency. And we have this slurry. And let it work its magic. Teflon pan, Teflon whisk. Flames up pretty high. Just to give you an idea, nothing just yet. See it starting to thicken? Same trick you'd use for your Thanksgiving dinner gravy. Kind of thicken it up a little bit, give it some really nice texture. And again, because it's going to be on like a slider and a bun, I want the sauce, the Marsala gravy, to kind of hold a little bit better onto our sandwich. There we go. And let the mushrooms absorb the Marsala wine, let it all kind of condense. You could make a roux and put it in here to thicken. I think it's just easier with the slurry. And just mix it. And I don't want clumps. I don't want nice and smooth sauce here. And you'll see again, starting to thicken up. Just a little more. And then there we go. And trust me, once you learn how to make this Marsala, you're gonna wanna take a bath in it. It is absolutely decadent delicious. And again, going in our clockwise pattern here. Turn this down to low. Just let it simmer. Let it all come together. Warm up that pork loin, make it nice and tender. Just let that be in a low simmer. All right, we're gonna let that reduce for a couple minutes. Got about a minute and a half on our sausage stuffed mushrooms. And we'll wrap everything up and put it all together. See you in a second. Okay, we are in the home stretch here, finally, with our super elevated appetizers. We've got our arugula, tomato, and crispy prosciutto sandwiches all set to go. Marsala's done. Buns are toasted for the Marsala. Let's take a peek at those stuffed mushrooms and see how we did. Put them in about 20 minutes. And you see, just a really fun little plate out of staple. Sausage and peppers. All we're gonna do is just plate these really simply. Just like that, and we're gonna serve those with some of our homemade sugu. And hopefully you caught our sugu and meatball recipes, which would be on our YouTube page. Got a plate all set here for our pork tenderloin sliders. Let's get in there with the old camera here. Again, bear with me, I'm a one-man show here, gang. You'll see just how beautifully that Marsala gravy came out, coats the spoon very, very nicely. And all we're gonna do, a nice piece of that pork loin, a couple of mushrooms, and if that ain't a slider, I don't know what is. Very flavorful, very delicious, very simple. We'll just make two for now. I'll save one for me for later. All right, we'll put everything together and wrap up the show. I'll be back in 1 second. Okay, everyone, thanks again for joining us here in Polly's Pantry. We're gonna try to come at you at least once a month with something new. It's hopefully something fun, something you'll have an interest in. Don't forget to check out the other videos on this YouTube page. We did one for sugo, basic marinara sauce, basic red sauce with some homemade meatballs. We did some pro tip videos and a little short video on frying eggplant as well. So we're here to wrap it up. We've got our little plan of BLT here with fresh tomato, arugula, and crispy prosciutto. Makes a really fun little kind of bite and a half appetizer. We've got our plate on sausage and peppers, sausage stuffed mini bell pepper, and we got the star of the show, our beautiful pork tenderloin Marsala sliders on just a toasted silver dollar roll. And there you have it, our take on some super elevated appetizers for whatever big game, for a nice date night, nice little buffet for Valentine's Day. Thanks again for joining us. We'll see you next time at the pantry. So long.